What is up, guys? Rick Kackis 14 here. Thank you so much for stopping by, and today, the Bungie Livestream for the brand new Season of Dawn coming to Destiny 2 has just concluded, and we have a bunch more information on this new season, and we're going to be going over all of that stuff in this video, and so let's get started. Now, first things first, let's look at the brand new content calendar reveal. Today, this is going to be showcasing what is coming when Season of Dawn launches and in the months after. So, on December 10th, which is the launch of this new season, we're going to have, for Season's Pass holders, the new seasonal PvE activity, the Sundial, and the Sundial Narul, the Hollow Voice, which seems to be the boss for that week. Then, for all Destiny players, we have the new seasonal artifact, of course, we have that big Solar subclass update, we have a new PvP mode with Elimination, Rusted Lands as a map is back in PvP rotation, and the Tangled Shore and Mars Obelisks are going to be open. Moving on from there, next reset on the 17th, we have the Nessus and EDZ obelisks that are open. We have the Sundial Ozalik, the Sky Piercer. So, yet another new Sundial boss. We're going to be talking more specifically about the Sundial in just a sec, but we also have Save a Legend. So it seems like this is going to be the quest or mission or whatever happens to go back in the timeline and save Saint 14. But that's actually not all. Also launching on this day is going to be the start of the Dawning event. As you can see, it goes from December 17th all the way till January 14th. And we can see a little bit of a teaser here of some of the exotic sparrows that are going to be present. Hopefully there's going to be a brand new weapon introduced as well. You know, last year it was the Avalanche machine gun, so I definitely want something similar to that to be present. Moving on from there, however, the week after, December 24th, we have the start of this season's Iron Banner, with again a little bit of a preview of apparently what this season's armor is going to look like. And if you look closely, well, not that close because I blew the image up, but the Titan is actually using a bow. Could this be a brand new Iron Banner bow coming next season? Well, it definitely could be because it appears that the Hunter is using the Kramil's Dagger hand cannon. Hard to tell what the Warlock is using, but there was a lot of criticism that this season's Iron Banner didn't offer any new weapons. Maybe this is Bungie's little hint on the fact that they are next season, which is really sweet. Then, also at the same reset, we have the Sundial. I'm not even gonna bother saying that name, the Sun Eater. Then, a week after that, we have Legend Sundial and the exotic quest for the Devil's Rune, which is the new, what appears to be, at least by screenshots, Solar Sidearm. I'm very excited for this because there's really not been too many exotic sidearms in all of Destiny's history. Not just Destiny 2, Destiny 1 included. So, really excited to get another one of those. Then, moving on from there, on January 28th, we have another exotic quest for the Bastion, and this does appear to be a fusion rifle. It looks like an auto rifle, but the file name actually has it listed as a fusion, so that's going to be interesting as well. Moving on from there, on February 4th, we have the Empyrean Foundation. I have no idea what that is. And then we have the Sundial, another boss being introduced. And the last thing on this calendar is for February 11th to the 18th, Crimson Days, as an event is back with some pretty crazy looking sparrows previewed there. All right, so that's what's coming. Let's dive into the specifics of the content. Firstly, I want to talk about the new Sundial activity. This is absolutely going to be the main thing in this season. You know, there's no mention of another raid. There's no mention of Trials of Osiris, despite the speculation. So it's really mainly the Sundial. The good news is that the Sundial seems like a way more substantial seasonal event than the previous seasonal event, well, the current seasonal event, which is Vex Offensive. There is way more weapons that seem to be present. In fact, during the gameplay today, we saw a fusion rifle being used. So that would bring the total, like, Saint 14 themed weapons that I've seen so far up to 6, which is definitely better than the 4 we've had with Vex Offensive. Not only that, the way the Sundial seems to work, according to Bungie, is that it has a lot more differentiation each time you play it. So you're going to go into this massive device in the center, and it's going to send you either to the past or to the present or to the future, like 3 different areas, each with their own tone to fight enemies. It does look like there's mechanics involved. They were picking up orbs, like they were killing special enemies that dropped orbs. Then they were throwing those orbs at shielded enemies to lower their shields. And it seems to be introducing these different bosses week to week. So we have the first week with the Hollow Voice boss. Then the next week, it's a different boss. Notably, this boss seems to be Arc Elemental. And then finally, we have the Sun Eater boss the week after that. This seems to be Solar, which would indicate that the starting boss is going to be Void. So you have a different boss every single week. And then much later, we have that final boss, which could be like extra powerful. Maybe it has all of the different elements. That would be an indication from this calendar. So that's definitely better, right? Then Vex Offensive, we had the same boss every single week until finally we have the Undying Mind. But this is 4 different bosses for the Sundial activity. Hopefully they all have unique mechanics to make this activity feel fresh every week. And the Legend Sundial is what I believe is the hard mode for the Sundial. Bungie did talk about the fact that just like Menagerie, there would be a hard or heroic version for Sundial, and it would require grabbing a team and going into that just like Heroic Menagerie. So it's kind of the hardcore version of this activity, and that is going to add yet another layer of depth. However, although the Sundial does seem like a great activity, is this one good activity enough for the season? Well, that's a discussion for another time. In any event, let's move on and talk about the brand new seasonal artifact, because it was shown off and we do have a look at some really cool new seasonal mods. So, here is the new artifact, the Lantern of Osiris. We can see that things are changed around quite a bit. In the very first column, we have all of the shield piercing and overload and unstoppable rounds for the different featured weapons. So this season, there's a focus on long range combat. So we have scout rifles, pulse rifles, bows, and auto rifles being featured here, which is definitely great. And this is going to allow players to unlock those like right off the bat and then go into the Sundial and actually have those active. In the second column, we see some of the discounted mods, again featuring long range weapons. So we have like enhanced linear fusion rifle targeting only costing 2. That's a big deal. Enhanced sniper loader is only going to cost 2 energy next season, which is huge because the Izanagi's Burden is like one of the best DPS outputting weapon in a lot of scenarios. So that is really going to improve PvE loadouts. And then we have the what looks like the glimmer increasing mods after that. And of course, the rest of the mods we don't exactly know. However, they did show off one of the final tier mods, and it is Guardian Angel. So it says, grants a chance to generate healing orbs for you on scout rifle, sniper rifle, bow, and linear fusion rifle precision final blows. And this is active in any part of the game. So if you're using a scout rifle, then that means you can potentially increase your survivability by running over these healing orbs quite a bit by utilizing this mod. And they did also say that the featured elements this new season are going to be Solar and Void. So expect the other mods to cover those subclasses. Okay, moving on from there, and this is one of the biggest features for this season, the seasonal mods are way more substantial, way more interesting in Season of Dawn. So, if you have an armor piece in Season of Dawn, obviously the final tier has the symbol for Season of Dawn, and it contains the new seasonal mods. You can still use the old seasonal armor with the old seasonal mod slot, which contains stuff like Nightmare, Banisher, and Relay Defender, all that stuff that was very specific to certain activities. But in Season of Dawn, those seasonal mods will cover a wide range of activities. So basically, the mods either let you become charged with light or use those charges of light and give you certain bonuses. So here's some examples. We have Shield Break Charge. Become charged with light by breaking an enemy shield with the matching energy type. The next example here, Empowered Finish. Become charged with light by finishing a combatant consuming 1/10 of your super energy. And lastly, we have Precisely Charged. Become charged with light by getting multiple rapid precision final blows with linear fusion rifles or snipe rifles, but putting on this mod will give you minus 10 discipline as a balancing factor, which is really cool that they're doing that now. So what do you do with that charge of light? Well, we see two mods that actually interact with it. So we have Protective Light, which while charged with light, you gain significant damage resistance against combatants when your shields are destroyed. This effect consumes all stacks of charged with light. The more stacks consumed, the longer the damage resistance lasts. Wow, so that's already a pretty decent bonus for getting charged. Like, you're using the other mods on other pieces of armor to get charged. Then when your shields get lowered, you get a huge damage resistance bump. Another mod we saw is High Energy Fire. While charged with light, gain a bonus to weapon damage. Each defeated enemy consumes one stack of charged with light. So remember, these are not only going to be active in PvE, but in PvP as well. And if that damage bonus is significant, then it could be really worth getting yourself charged with light and then utilizing this mod, for example, to break that charge and get that insane damage bonus. Oh, and one final thing, you can pull out your Sparrow on Mercury. That's right, Mercury is going to be kind of the featured planet next season, and the fact that you had to walk everywhere is super frustrating. I know me, I still try to whip up my Sparrow almost every time I load into Mercury when I'm doing strikes or so on, and I remember, oh wait, you can't, so that's gonna make things just a lot more user-friendly while on that planet. Guys, that's it for the video. I hope you enjoyed, found this informative, and if you did, please remember to help me out by simply rating and especially sharing this video. If you guys want to see more Destiny 2 content similar to this, don't be afraid to slap that subscribe button. And if you want to get in touch with me and keep up to date with the latest channel activity, the best way is to follow me on Twitter at @RickKackis. That's linked in the description down below. Again, I hope you enjoyed the video, and as always, have a good day.